My name is Kunle Odunsi. I am the Deputy Director at Roswell Park Comprehensive Cancer Center. I also chair the Department of Gynecologic Oncology, and I also serve as the Executive Director of the Center for Immunotherapy at Roswell Park. STIC stands for serous tubal intraepithelial carcinoma. That's a long name, but it simply stands for precancerous changes that take place within the fallopian tube. For the longest time, we thought ovarian cancers arise from the lining cells on the surface of the ovaries. But it became very clear to us over the past 10 years or so that many ovarian cancers actually arise from the fallopian tube. So then the question becomes, what are the initial changes that happen before they become cancers? So it turns out that STICs are the precursor lesions. STICs are the abnormal cells that eventually give rise to ovarian cancers as we know them. Our goal is to try and assemble all STIC lesions that we can lay our hands upon and ask the question, what is the identity? What do these abnormal, early abnormal cells, what are they making that we can use as a biomarker for early detection of STICs? So in order to do that, we plan to assemble as many STIC lesions as possible. Fallopian tubes from women who have undergone surgery where a STIC has been found. We plan to assemble those fallopian tubes from across the country through a network of collaborators. And then we look under the microscope and we dissect out those abnormal cells and interrogate them and ask the question, what are you making that we can then check in the blood for early detection? We are open to collaboration with other research teams, and in fact, this initial funding by the DOD is actually phase one of the funding for us to create this infrastructure and demonstrate some proof of principle. Then we go on to a phase two where we really want to extend the network and potentially collect STIC lesions prospectively as they are diagnosed in multiple institutions across the United States. The more biospecimens that we have access to, the more likely we are to succeed. Every participating site will be able to initially send virtual images of STICs, which will be reviewed by a central committee of pathologists, very experienced and highly skilled pathologists, to validate that in fact what we're looking at is a STIC lesion. Then the specimen, the biospecimen, gets sent to Inova Sher Cancer Institute, where the laser capture micro dissection is performed, and also the proteomics analysis is performed. Some of the specimens are then sent back to Roswell Park, to MD Anderson, and to Mayo Clinic to do different types of analysis. So everybody's bringing their special expertise to the table in order to attack this problem. So for any institution to participate, all they need to do is to contact myself or Dr. Larry Maxwell or Dr. Anil Sood at MD Anderson, Dr. Bob Bast also at MD Anderson, or Dr. Kaufman at the Mayo Clinic. So the network is going to be very broad. Not only the key institutions, Roswell Park, Mayo Clinic, MD Anderson, and Inova Sher, but we're hoping to expand the network to every corner of the United States so that we can really solve this problem.